rights than cybercrime is more active during this COVID time. And actually, we saw the rise of cybercrime activity in April when there was lockdown in Europe, and exactly that time, cybercriminals released more malware to the networks. They were more hacking attempts, and we have statistics actually. We have statistics for countries. It's on our securelist.com website in the statistics. So you may take this data yourself if you're interested in. So actually, our Virus Lab reported that we collected about plus 8% of malicious code, which was developed by criminals, used by criminals. There were about plus 20-25% of the hackers' activity, in some regions, in some countries, there were 10 times more web attacks. So actually, this data is a little bit different from country to country. So that was in April. In May, surprise, the hackers, they were less active than usual. I don't think that they celebrated the 1st of May Labor Day, or did they do it for the whole month? Well, I don't know. Actually, we have no idea why the cyber criminals, they were less active in May. But in June and July, they got back to the April level. So the bad guys, they use the opportunity of COVID time to hack more victims. And actually, we were able to predict that, because when the people there moved home, they stay at home, of course, they spend more time in the internet. So the bad guys, they have more victims online. At the same time, there are many companies, they work online. So there, for hackers, there was opportunity to hack the enterprises through the home computers, because not every enterprise guaranteed the same cybersecurity for the home, for the employees working from home. We have these reports that hackers, the criminals were hacking the enterprise through the home computers. So the COVID time, the pandemic, didn't damage the cyber criminal business. Obviously, because cybercrime, they work from home and they do work from home. What's going on with businesses which got online? Actually, not every company, not every enterprise had resources and knowledge how to provide cybersecurity to every employee. There is not many things we need to do to guarantee the same level of security. We need just have the good enough endpoint security. You have to have a VPN connection to the office network, at least two factors authentication, and basically that's it. So we can guarantee the same. So you stay at home, but you're virtually working from your corporate environment. So you're protected by the corporate security. But unfortunately, not many enterprises, not many businesses, they're able to do that. They don't have resources. And actually, that was a very good shift for the security companies, our partners, to provide more services, not just products, but services to manage security. So I think that this COVID time will accelerate the managed security services globally. So I think it's a visible shift in a cybersecurity industry landscape. The espionage, which is still not disclosed, not discovered yet. In the cyber world, actually, there is no... The projects which are going on, the good and bad stuff, actually there's no impact from this COVID time. So the software engineers, they work as usual, most of them. That's true about espionage campaign as well. So I guess we'll have more news later this year, and we have some stuff to present at next SaaS conference. I guess that we have no new versions of Stuxnet, so actually we have no more machine code to learn from. What about Stuxnet? Of course, it's a very interesting. What really happened? who was behind that and who did the components of that malware. How much did they invest into the project? How did they deploy the project to the victim site? But it's not our job to answer these questions because it's not machine code. So we don't have abilities, so we don't have skills how to investigate so deep. So we can read the machine code. So what we know it's from the binaries which we receive from in some way. But since that we didn't have any new modifications, any new variants of Stuxnet, so I guess that's now with Stuxnet in our archives. We learned everything 10 years ago, and maybe next year after that.